Welcome to the Macon Coliseum in Macon, Georgia. It's the Georgia High School Association Class Single A Division II Championship presented by Breda Pest Management, the official sponsor of high school basketball, as the 10-time state champion Wilkinson County Warriors take on the Cinderella story, the Charlton County Indians. And good afternoon. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former McDonald's All-American and Georgia Bulldogs point guard Sean Golden. And Sean, from a historical perspective, we've got a David versus Goliath matchup in our first game.
Interesting matchup in a unique way. You've got two programs, one that's been on the top with the legendary Dr. Jeter, and that's Tim Whipple taking over for him. I got to play the LSU, has a chance now to cut down his nets for the first time. And then you come in with Coach Bailey at Charlton County. This team, this program has never made it to the championship, and we're looking forward to a good game.
Wilkinson 24-6 on the season, seeking their first state title since 2018 and led by their fabulous point guard, DeCartier Craig.
Interesting thing about him, he's a floor general. Number two in the nation with assists, number one in the state with assists, averaging 12 per game.
And for Charlton County, at 29-2 on the season, two incredible sophomores led by the three-point sharpshooter, Jarvis Wright.
He's a scorer, he's a shooter, number two in the state. Number two in the nation with three-point shooting, averaging 20 points per game. It's going to be a lightning game this afternoon.
He has hit a phenomenal 168 three-pointers this season. That's an average of 5 three-pointers per game. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. They are powered by the Dairy Alliance. You go to DeCartier Craig, Justin Stanley, their leading scorer, Quavion Hill, Seconius Sinkfield, and Jordan Jackson, their big guy in the middle. And for the Indians, Demorian Martin in the backcourt, Jarvis Wright, Jamari Hamilton, Jalen King, who's been a four-year starter for Coach David Bailey's team and the heart and soul, and Elias Williams, that other super-duper sophomore, averaging 17 points, 12 rebounds, and close to 5 block shots per game.
Well, both teams want to get out. Transition is important. Definitely got to make baskets. But here's the thing in talking to all coaches. The first 4 minutes of a championship game is going to determine the tempo of it. Going to watch how this game starts and see how it affects how the game finishes.
Dairy Alliance, global advocates for dairy as an essential ingredient to life. So just about set to tip off our first of 8 boys championship games from the Macon Coliseum. Charlton County, 29-2 overall on the season. They were the Region 2 champions with a record of 9-1, the number one seed. Charlton County went 16-0, 8-2 away from home, and 5-0 on the neutral site. And in the Georgia High School Tournament, 50-49, Final Four winners over number one Green Forest and their 2 7-footers. They shocked the world, Sean, when they knocked off Green Forest, a perennial power.
Well, you got to do that to get to a championship. Sometimes you got to win games you're not supposed to win. But now you hear it's a one-game season. Both teams want to do extra things. You talk about Wilkinson County. They want to defend, not overhelp. It limit the turnovers in transition, and then Charlton, they want to come in and attack the 2-2-1 press.
Wilkinson County, on the other hand, they were 10-0 at home, 10-0 in the region, and the Region 5 champions, 12-2 at home, and they were 85-63 Final Four winners over Macon County in the state semifinals.
You can hear the excitement. You can feel the excitement because you got Wilkinson County back, but Charlton County, they're like, listen, if we can win this game tonight, we can start our own dynasty.
Sean, as you mentioned, Xavier Whipple going after his first state championship after 9 seasons as an assistant to the legendary coach, Dr. Aaron Jeter. He started LSU, and Charlton County is going to start on offense, and we've got our charging foul, or do we have a blocking foul? Looks like we've got a charge on the opening play. Jamari Hamilton's going to be whistled for the foul.
Well, aggression started offensively, but the defense came in and took a charge, so it showed you the balance of what both teams want to do.
Wilkinson County averaged 71.8 points per game during the regular season and gave up only 54.5. They dump into the low post on the wing. The jumper, Quavion Hill, bounces off the top of the backboard. Offensive rebound underneath, and the defensive rebound controlled by Elias Williams, who averages a double-double. and had 21 double-doubles on the season. Three-pointer from straight away. Jarvis Wright with the first of many.
When we talked about it, Matt, transition basketball and the first 4 minutes, you see everyone's trying to attack, either get to the rim or shoot the open three whenever it presents itself.
So Charlton County with the early lead. Feed to the low block, challenged underneath. Rebound pulled down by Williams again. And that's going to be Wilkinson County's game, Sean. They're going to do a lot of dribble drive, try to draw fouls, get to the free throw line.
Well, everyone wants to play great at the beginning, but now you got to understand there's two charges. Some point of the time in the game, you got to slow down. The game is fast, but you play quick and smart, but not fast and out of control.
Damarian Martin was called for the charge. There's a look at David Bailey. What an incredible job he has done with Charlton County. 73-38 in his four seasons. Prior to this year, the deepest run that Charlton County had ever made in the state playoffs was the Elite Eight in 1996.
Well, you see, driving to the basket, Wilkinson County trying to really establish themselves with the attack opportunities, attack mode, but defense is the key. You've got to be under control, eliminate turnovers, but also you want to attack to get open shots.
Jarvis Wright was called for that foul. Another miss by Wilkinson County from the three-point line, and a battle underneath. And traveling is going to be the call.
Well, when it comes to shooting three-point shots, you got to understand defensively, they're not going to be short rebounds in the paint. They're going to be long, so all five players at some point in time have to box out so you can eliminate second-chance scoring opportunities.
Wilkinson County has started 0-for-3 from the field in this game. Inside they go to Williams. Corner three. Williams battles for the offensive rebound. Wilkinson comes away with it.
That's called gang rebound. A great job by Wilkinson County eliminating the second chance scoring opportunities. And now in transition for another shot.
Slashing through the paint and the bank in. Justin Stanley, who averages 21 points per game.
It's a Wednesday afternoon. The bank is open.
Corner three off the iron. Offensive rebound to keep it alive for the Indians. Stolen away. Dribble drive, slashing to the basket. Stanley missed the layup. And you got to wonder, Sean, do we have some nerves at play here? Because they're missing some open looks.
Well, that's okay, because you're getting the shots out of your system. If it's a nervous opportunity, that's okay. Nerves are okay right now. But again, what we talked about, the first 4 minutes, you have to stay aggressive when both teams are in attack mode.
Lid still on the basket for Wilco. Another missed layup underneath. That one by Hamilton, but the follow and a 5-2 lead for Charlton County.
Even though you make the basket, you got to get back on defense. Look at Wilkinson County coming right back in attack mode.
Jamari Hamilton running the offense from the top. Four out, one in. Inside they go to Williams. Williams misses with the left hand, goes up with the right hand and puts it in.
He's a big kid in the inside, long, almost like a unicorn type of athlete. And the thing is, averaging 17 and 12 for the season, you've got to get the ball into him to establish his presence inside, especially early in the game.
6'9", 215, already drawing looks from Kirby Smart and Mike Norvell. Williams, corner three. Bang!
And that was started with Williams. Even though he had a chance to attack the rim, he didn't want to pick up the easy foul, kicked it for the open three. So that was good offensive play, great mindset by Williams to hit it to the open shooter.
In the paint, rattles around, offensive stick back. Wilco starting to come to life offensively and cash in on those rebounds on the offensive end. King off back iron. Rebound controlled by Wilco and Quavion Hill.
So now you're going to 7 minutes into the game. Now it's time to come down. Let's get easy baskets. Hit the open shot, but get easy baskets.
And ball out of bounds. We reach our first timeout of the first quarter. Charlton County on top, 10-6. Inside, Elias Williams battling.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your breath, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
The play in the first quarter and a 10-6 lead for Charlton County. Wilco has hit two of their last three shots. Charlton, two of their last four. Starting to heat things up a little bit as you take a look at David Bailey. First two seasons, they went 22-38, Sean. Last two seasons, they've been 51-10.
Well, he's an up-and-coming superstar in this game in the state of Georgia. You hear his name often because he's got a chance to do something special and win this championship against a powerhouse like Wilkinson County.
He has put Charlton County on the basketball map. When he first got there, Sean, he said nobody came to the gym. Now they've got a live DJ. You got to get there early to get a ticket. They come running through the crowd, slapping hands. He's turned it into a party. Basketball has become a thing in Folkston.
Well, if you watch what happened right then, here's Williams, the big guy. He wasn't the first option, wasn't the second option. He was the third option. Look at him. He's athletic. He's strong. He's finishing down low, gets the opportunity to go to the free throw line. He's the kind of player you want on your team because he's not going to call for the ball every single time, but it's going to give 100% effort offensively and defensively, and he'll be a big team player.
Elias Williams misses his first free throw. He's a 76% free throw shooter. The foul was called on DeCartier Craig.
And Matt, I think about Williams there in that last play. You talking about Kirby Smart and his hands. This kid, every time he catches a ball in the paint, it's not a turnover. I mean, he's got great hands. He's got a soft touch at the basket, and that's what you want your big guy to have, good hands.
Jarvis Wright, spot up three, and the rebound yanked down by Hill. So 6'9", 215, you got the Georgia coach, the Florida State football coach, looking at you. Is this a guy a tight end, or is he a D end?
He's whatever he can play. I mean, look at his size. Look at his ability. Yeah, he's whatever he can play on the field or on the court.
Or maybe he just sticks with hoops. He's pretty good at that, too. The drive on the baseline. Foul's going to be called on Jalen King going for the block. That'll be the first personal foul on King. And that'll be the fourth team foul on Charlton County here in the quarter. Free throw miss, Quavion Hill.
Coach's cousin. Here's a guy that's, you know, second leading scorer on the team. So he's going to have to step up his scoring for Wilkinson County for them to excel and win this championship today.
Wow, tight rims, bounced around and goes out of bounds. But you're right, Coach's cousin, and when you are in Folkestone, or rather, pardon me, when you're in Wilkinson County, everybody in a way is related to the Whipples. In fact, when Xavier was a senior, they had 9 Whipples on the football team. They called it Whippleville.
Yes, they did, and I'm sure there's a lot of Whipples in that stands today, but here's Williams again. There's been a presence down low. Gets a great rebound with 2 strong hands. Man, I love him. He could be a guy that can play both basketball and football.
Williams inside, and we're going to have a foul called on Wilco. This is going to go against Jordan Jackson.
Don't know if that was a foul. More of a flop. I mean, the big kid has great presence, great footwork. To me, he's really the best prospect on the court to think of basketball.
Inside block. Elias Williams sent that one back.
And the thing about Elias Williams I love, Matt, is here's a guy who's excelling here early in the first half on the offensive end and the defensive end. And just love the way he's playing under control and making his presence known when the ball is given to him.
Now, apparently on that previous play on the last position, the foul was called on Williams, an offensive foul and not a defensive foul. We'll have a blocking foul right here on Wilco.
See the verticality? Block the ball at its height. The verticality there. He's smart, really. If you watch him play, the ball just went into him the last time, kicked it back out for the open shooter. He avoids the charge and transition. Kind of a flop there when he got the ball inside, but I love watching this kid play.
5-point lead for the Indians, final minute of this first quarter. Now the clock is not running, so the officials are going to step in and fix that. They actually inbounded the ball with 56 seconds, so they take 3 seconds off the clock and fix it. They still haven't reset the shot clock. You should take 3 seconds off the shot clock, too. There they go. Wilco, 3-for-16, 19% shooting in the first quarter. Drive, contested, and Williams got another block.
Man, look at him run, jump right down the court, man. Right down the middle of the court, force the defense to commit, and there's the open three.
How
great
about
basketball.
That, though? They missed the slashing Williams. He had a layup.
Well, you didn't want to give it to him too late. That was smart basketball because once a post player gets past the free throw line, he's going to be out of control. But he forced the defense to commit, which gave the open three-point shot.
Charlton County not shooting a whole lot better, but better. They're 4-for-12, 33%, and 2-for-7 on threes. Charlton has missed their last 4 shots. Wilco, their last 7.
And see, if you're Charlton County, you have 17.4 in the game, 17 on the shot clock. Pretty much pull the ball out, get the last shot, go into the first quarter, out of the first quarter with a 5-point lead.
10 seconds to play in the quarter. Down to five, going to have to do something with it. Step in at the foul line, and that is the end of the quarter. 11-6, Charlton County on top here in the first quarter of the Class 1A D2 Championship, and Elias Williams has been as good as advertised.
It's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Start of the second quarter in Charlton County on top of Wilkinson County, 11-6. And Elias Williams, young man, has been a beast in the first quarter. He scored only 3 points, but he has 8 rebounds and 3 block shots already in this game.
Well, you look at his body right here, his physique. We talk about him being just interesting athlete, a guy that plays both football but basketball, has great hands. I love his IQ on the court. And every time, Matt, he goes to adjust or contest shots, he doesn't foul with his body. He goes straight up with the verticality to change the shot, or to contest it or get the 3 blocks like he had there in the first quarter.
He has 119 total blocks this season. Let that soak in for a minute.
Well, you keep
high school.
You can't keep challenging the big fella. You know, shoot the ball outside, but definitely do not bring it inside the paint.
In the paint, shot an air ball, slips out of the hands of Travion Evans and out of bounds. And Wilco just can't get untracked.
Well, because of the big kid inside, Williams, I mean, he's clogging up the paint. And Wilkinson County, they're not shooting the ball pretty good right now. They're not. They're shooting the ball pretty at a par or below par pace. So they've got to pick the ball up, maybe score in transition more before the defense can get set.
There's Williams. Had a triple team on him, and a 3-second violation.
Well, again, good offense by Charlton County. And Williams was the ideal person to receive the ball, but after the action, he gets the ball in the paint, they triple team him, kicks it out. Got charged with a 3-second call.
Inside the fadeaway, rebound by Jalen King. Wilco has missed their last 10 shots in this game. Baseline jumper. Neither team lighting it up, but Charlton County has been a little bit better. Drive and got it up there, left it short, and that's a situation where Elias Williams got him thinking about it. He leaves the layup short.
And his presence was felt, even though he was nowhere near the shooter, his presence was felt with 3 blocks in the first quarter.
I like David Bailey's work. Look, man, he's dressed old school Armani suit, right?
He's looking good. First time, like Deion said, look good, feel good, coach good.
I think coaches, I like them when they dress like Jay Wright and like the old like Pat Riley. I'm not big into the Star Trek warm-up uniforms these days. Look at that, 3 for 22 for Wilco in this game. We still have not had a field goal from either team since the 3:21 mark of this quarter. In the paint, high off the glass to avoid the block. And we'll have a foul called on Charlton County.
Well, you can also, Matt, you can add it to the depth possession there. The depth possession there at Macon, because you know, most teams are, both teams are accustomed to playing in small facilities.
Yeah.
So now when you get into a bigger facility, you got bigger space, they're not used to it. You just got to shoot yourself out of the low.
Yep.
Stay aggressive. When you become passive, now you give the advantage to the opposing team. Both teams just stay aggressive.
What was the biggest environment as far as a stadium size that you had to play in and had to adjust to?
Rupp Arena.
Yeah.
Rupp Arena is a place you want to play. You think of Kansas and Allen Fogg Fieldhouse, that was an interesting place. But the most fearful place was, I would say, down in Florida in the swamp. Listen, you had fans right there and you're in your bench. So basketball is one of those things. It depends on where you play and how you play.
Elias Williams gets another rebound. He might break a rebounding record because Wilco has given him plenty of opportunity to grab caroms. They've made only 3 buckets so far in this game. King strokes it at the foul line.
Well, the patience from the offense was there. You're getting it at the high post. Good stroke, good finish. Those are the kind of baskets you want to have.
Another block by Williams. At some point, you got to stop challenging the big guy, right?
But you got to look at the way he defends, Matt. He's not swinging at the ball. He's not swatting at the ball. Verticality, he's going straight up and meeting the ball at its height.
That was like a volleyball block at the net, wasn't it?
That's just smart basketball. That's also smart coaching. Because most players are the post player. You want to block shots versus contest and meet it high.
Finally, a run-out opportunity for Wilco, and they missed the layup. They had 3 men back and didn't get any points. Inside, King, Williams offensive glass. Everybody's playing so fast. I think it's the nerves of the state championship game. Instead of bringing the ball down and taking it back up, which Elias Williams at 6'9 ought to be able to do.
Yeah.
We've got our first commercial break of the second quarter coming up with Charlton County leading 13-6.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your breath, got me feeling so good away.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
So, Sean, if you're Xavier Whipple over in the Wilco huddle, what's the message to your team? They've missed 16 straight shots in their 3 for 25 shooting in the game.
I'm going to talk like Coach Durham right now. Everyone wants to be a hero. And if you think about it, six of the seven players that have played have taken shot attempts. Your top scorer, who averages 21 points a game, has only two. Let's get it to the guys that's got us here. Put it in Stanley's hand. The kid can score the ball, but everyone cannot go down being a hero trying to win a state championship game.
Stanley has 2 points. He's 1 for 7 shooting. Stolen pass by the Indians. Meantime, the big fella, Elias Williams, on the bench with 2 personal fouls. He has 4 blocks. That might be the best news for Wilco the entire game, that they got him on the bench with 2 fouls. And a timeout's going to be called by Charlton County. 30-second timeout. So this is where you have to take advantage of the fact the 6'9 rim protectors no longer on the floor.
Well, yes. If you're Wilkinson County, you're right. But Charlton County, we don't have our big guy in there, so we don't need to score so early in possession. The shot clock, the game clock is our friend. So let's run our offense and get high percentage shot opportunities.
Elias Williams, spectacular game so far, but he is on the bench now with the 2 personal fouls, 3 points, 11 rebounds, and 4 blocks. In the first 12 minutes of this game. But you got to take advantage of Sal Wilco with him on the bench. Got a much smaller lineup on the floor right now for Charlton County. And a shot clock violation.
And in situations like that, that's where your point guard and your coach, this is their first year now, so there are going to be some mistakes along the journey. And he'll learn from that, because I'm sure that possession is going to present itself in his second half or sometime here in the near future in this game.
Good news for Wilco is they've missed 16 straight shots, and they're still down only 7. They only need a couple of makes to make up the difference. Inside, they keep it alive, and you can tell with Williams not in there, DeCartier Craig is able to get the offensive rebound and the putback off his miss.
Yeah, but, you know, the thing about DeCartier Craig, here's a guy that's averaging 12 assists a game. Because the penetration is not there for the kick, he's forced to score, which is pretty much not his strength, to get him to a position where he's number one in the state, number two in the nation, and getting the ball to the open player.
Fumbled away, scramble for it, and Wilco has it. Long lead pass and unable to save it, and it goes back to Charlton County. Now they're playing 5-on-4, step through, and we'll have a blocking foul on Wilco.
Great call by the official. The defense was not set, tried to create the charge with no contact. So that was a great job right there by the officiating.
Sinkfield picks up his first personal foul. 3 team fouls now on Wilco. And Jamarian Hamilton, who's only a 48% free throw shooter, gets the first make.
Now let's look at what we have. We've got 3 minutes left in the first half. Charlton County's up by 6, and your best player is on the court with 2 fouls. If you're Charlton County, it's not about outscoring them. It's about, let's go ahead and keep Wilkinson County down offensively, because they're going to go into halftime with question marks why they can't score the ball.
Sinkfield the rebound. It's a 14-8 game, under 3 minutes to play first half. But I think I totally agree with you. The depth perception issue probably got a lot to do with it. These teams are not accustomed to playing in a big arena environment, and they don't get time to come out here and get acclimated to it. It's not like you come in the day before and it's the playoffs and you get a walkthrough or something like that.
Well, there's the coach's cousin again with the mid-range jump shot, because the big fellow wasn't there to contest it. So that's good basketball for Wilkinson County, getting it to one of your guys that can put the ball into the basket.
So Wilkinson County starting to show some life on offense, and that's going to be a traveling call on Charlton County.
And see, Charlton County needs to slow down. Use at least 28 to 30 seconds on the shot clock, because you want to go in with a lead in halftime.
Wilco with a 14-game winning streak. Corner three. Offensive rebound. Jordan Jackson missed up close, and Jalen King snags the board for Charlton County.
But you see now that Williams being out of the game, there's second chance scoring opportunities there for Wilkinson County, because Charlton County is not taking down that first rebound. They're taking down the second or the third.
Mid-range jumper and a foul on the shot. We'll put Jarvis Wright at the line.
And I think, Matt, here in the first half, I don't think there's strategy. I think there's, let's go into the game and see what the opposing team has given us. Both coaches have not used strategy yet. And that's okay, because it's only a five-point lead. It could easily be a tie game going into the half. But the second half, I think that's when the strategy starts to come out and you see a different kind of game plan going forward.
Jordan Tolliver in the game for Charlton County for the first time. 6-point lead for the Indians. 90 seconds to play in the half. The dribble drive and the bank in by Quavion Hill. Third bucket for him. Hill has 6 of their 12 points. And that's going to be an offensive foul.
But look at the shot clock. 18 seconds on the shot clock. That's very early in that possession to attack, especially being up by 4 points. And I'm sure that Coach Bailey and his staff will address that. Guys, we got a big fella on the bench. Stop being so aggressive early in the shot clock. Take your time.
That'll be the second personal foul on Hamilton. So now they've got 3 players with 2 fouls each, Martin Williams and Hamilton. And Wilco has now hit 4 of their last 6 shots. After missing 16 straight, they pulled within 2.
Well, the tempo of the game has slowed down. Now we're going into the end of the first half, and defensive transition baskets are now helping Wilkinson County get that momentum.
Game tied on the steal and layup by Jordan Jackson. You can hear the folks from Whippleville getting excited. ...25 seconds to play in the half. Kicked away by Charlton County. They get it back. They got an opportunity here with a broken floor, and Wright knocks down the shot.
Big time basket by Wright. Here's a guy who can shoot the ball. He's one of the top shooters, 3-point shooters in the nation. So it was time for him to knock down one.
That was a 2 just inside the arc. And then Wilco, back the other way, throws it out of bounds.
But again, I think both teams got to get it to your players who got you here. Everyone can't be the hero. Everyone cannot be the hero. Wright should be touching the ball every possession now coming down the court, because he's a deadly shooter and he has a high percentage of getting into the basket.
Yeah, they've changed the Wright shot to a 3-point shot, so 19-16 the score. Rebound in the paint, up and in the basket by the buzzer. They're going to wave it off and say that Jordan Tolliver did not get it off in time. And a 19-16 lead for the Indians. Let's take another look at it. Did Tolliver get it off in time?
Oh, that's pretty close.
I think he got it off in time.
That's pretty close.
If the light on the backboard is true, he got it off in time. It is out of his hand right
the
there.
Fingertip. It's the index finger.
You
it's
think?
The index finger.
It's hard to tell from that angle. It's very, very close. I think he got it off.
I think he got it off.
I think he got it off, but the officials said no shot.
Are they reviewing it at the table?
So 19-16, Charlton County on top of Wilkinson County. Let's send it to Hannah Gooden.
Thank you, Matt. Coming up on the halftime show, we'll break down what's happened and what's to come on our GHSA championship coverage. Check in with John at Macon Coliseum and hear from some special guests. It's all next right here on GPB Sports.
the best defense to stopping bugs and critters? That would be Breda Pest Management, protecting homes all over Georgia for nearly 50 years. See why so many homes are protected by Breda Pest Management at BREDAPest.com.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumber!
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's faking your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and makes moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, just really hadn't thought about it.
Gooden. We're live from the GBB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of the GHSA Single A Division II Boys Championship game between Wilkinson County and Charlton County. Let's get you caught up on what's happened and what's to come on our GBB Championship scoreboard. So here's the game that we are in right now. It's the first championship appearance for the Indians, while the Warriors have won 10, the last being in 2018. Wilkinson County up 19-16 at the half. At 1 o'clock, it was the Single A Division II Girls Championship between Clinch County and Lake Oconee. Clinch County took down the defending champs 45-42 for the Panthers' first state title since 1993. And then coming up this evening at 5 o'clock, Quad A Girls Baldwin versus Griffin. And at 7 o'clock, 4A Boys Fayette County versus Pace Academy. This is day one of four, so a lot more basketball action ahead and more to come from the halftime show. We'll be right back with some special guests.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure, we support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons, lighting up good business so business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Welcome back. It's halftime of the GHSA Single A Division II Boys Championship game between Wilkinson County and Charlton County. Let's check in with John Nelson, who's standing by with the Warriors and Indians principals at Macon Coliseum.
Hannah, it is that time. I'm in the principal's office. I've got Danny McCoy, the principal from Charlton County, off to my left, off to camera right, and also hanging out Sheree Lewis. the leader of the Blue Storm, coming down from Irwinton. Let me start ladies first, Chivalry. Let's go Chivalry. What's it like to be back chasing after title number 11?
It feels like coming home. After winning 10 state championships, we're ready for our next one.
Now, really quickly, I noticed that it's a part of the fabric. And for those that don't know, how much of the fabric is basketball to Wilkinson County?
It means a lot, but more importantly, we nurture student athletes. Our vision is making students competent builders of a globally competitive future. So we truly believe if we nurture that in the classrooms, we can nurture it on the court, and we make well-rounded students.
No doubt about it. Let's go to the flip side, catch up with Coach McCoy. What's it like having your rivals from the Swamp here cheering you on? Clinch County State.
Yeah, it's a little different. We actually cheered for probably the first time I've ever cheered for Clinch today in their final, and luckily they won. And we're here for the first time against a perennial power, and we're trying to get our first win in boys basketball. We've got them in a lot of sports, but this would be our first trip in boys basketball.
What's it like to see the support quickly?
Oh, man, it's been a blessing. The community's rallied around Coach Bailey. He's done a great job. He came here 4 years ago when I became the high school principal, and he's a quality individual, and the values he instills in our players are tremendous. That means more than anything he does.
That's our time in the principal's office. Principal McCoy from Charlton.
Thank you.
Principal Lewis from Wilco. Let's send it back to you, Hannah.
Thanks, John. Great to hear from them. We have to take one more quick break, but stick around for a breakdown of the first half.
It's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
I've been checking food labels for years. I like to buy local, and I like to buy healthy for my family. So I started checking the labels on our clothes, too. Did you know synthetic fibers like polyester are pretty much made of oil? No thanks. I look for cotton now, which grows right here in Georgia, a major source of the world's cotton. Cotton is natural, renewable, sustainable, and buying cotton supports Georgia farmers. Good enough for me and my family.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a villain, I'm standing in the right space. Breathing your past, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Welcome back. It's time to break down the first half with John Nelson. And John, Coach Whipple and Wilkinson County made some really good adjustments there in the first half when they were down early. What did you see?
When you look at what happened, Hannah, in that first half, you saw, I mean, both teams combined 14 of 54 from the floor, and I think that Sean and Matt had a great point when it came to getting adjusted to a building this size. You were down 11-6 if you're Wilco, then you come back, and it ends up being that back-and-forth game that we anticipated. Desperation, it seemed, on both sides, trying to either close the margin or work your way through it and advance your lead if you're Charlton or Wilco. Really interesting to see how pacing is going to be. Are we going to continue to see that frantic pace in the second half starting here with the second 16 minutes? Really, really interesting here in the first half. I want to see if the shooting does improve, by the way. Back to you.
Thanks, John. Well, let's find out. Let's send it to Matt and Sean in the studio for more from the second half.
All right. Thank you, Hannah. Interesting first half, 19-16. Sean, what was the message from each coach in the locker room as they prepare for the second half and try to win a state championship?
If I'm Coach Whipple, let's get it to the players that can score. And we talked about it. Everyone wants to be the hero, but we don't need heroes. We need guys that can come out here and play your game. When your top player averaging 20-something points a game only has 2 points, that's a problem. And then on the other end, if you're Charlton County, your big fella's in foul trouble. let's continue to attack the ball when it gets back in. Slow down, because you're going to get second chance scoring opportunities to actually add to your aggression and your ability to win on the glass. So that's two of the things you definitely have to talk about on both sides of the ball.
From an individual standout, Elias Williams was the star of that first half with four block shots. Yes, I am.
All right, let's get ready for the second half. Get ready for the second half here with Charlton County. You see Elias Williams, who came out 11 rebounds, but remember the foul trouble for Charlton County. Two fouls each for Damarian Martin, for Jamari Hamilton, and for that guy right there, Elias Williams. 1 of 4 from the floor, but 11 rebounds. Came up big for Charlton County in the first 16 minutes. So let's see what happens here. Charlton County in their white outfits with the red numerals and the black piping and the main blue and gold for Wilco. As we get you ready here from the Macon Coliseum and the Macon Centerplex, second half championship game of two on the day. And we're underway. Back and forth, 14 of 54, both teams in the first half. Let's see if it improves here as we start the third quarter. Whistle early on, 10 seconds in. We've got our first foul on Wilkinson County. Looks like it's on Jordan Jackson. So that will be Jackson's first personal foul. Wright thought about driving into the paint, pulls it back, and resetting Jamari Hamilton at the circle. Jalen King. Wright looking inside. Up and in with the right hand. Elias Williams, he now has 5 points. Charlton County's lead back up to 5 at 21-16. Go working the perimeter, tries to pass inside. Last touch by Charlton County. 23 left on the shot clock. 7:18 to go here, third quarter. All apologies, we got technical problems back in Atlanta. So I'll be doing play-by-play for a little bit. Blocking the inside by Hamilton. Up and in and count it. Or are they going to say that it happened before the foul? Fouls on Elias Williams. It's his third. Let's take another look. See the challenge. It's on the second challenge by Williams that got the foul. Inside, high floater off the back of the rim. No, hard ball by DeCartier Craig. We're going to keep an eye on this. Went up for the shot, landed hard on his back. Xavier Whipple obviously concerned. Good to see Craig up on his feet. Hard impact on this floor. Let's take another look. Off the back of the rim, challenging for the rebound with Williams. And he hit the deck. 1 minute gone, 57 seconds. Let's send it back to Goldie and Matt for the third quarter.
All right. Thank you, Nelly. Good job there. Stepping in. Big pinch hit by John Nelson, man on the scene. Thanks, man. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Charlton County on offense, leading by 5 here, early third quarter. Matt Stewart along with Sean Golden. Thanks for joining us day one of the GHSA State Basketball Championships, and this is the Class 1A D2 Championship game. Charlton County trying to win their first ever state championship.
And Matt, we talk about strategy. Here in the second half, Charlton County doing some extra movement on the baseline, trying to get the ball to Williams. Just a missed shot down on perimeter. And now you've got Wilkinson County in attack mode on offense.
Right there in the middle, the left-handed shot up and in, Travion Evans.
And so Evans not going too deep, knowing the big fella was inside the paint, trying to contest and block shots. So instead of trying to go for the layup, hit the 10-foot floater, and that's what happened there in that possession.
Inside they go. The dunk attempt and a foul is going to be called on Wilco.
He is hard to defend. And I say this because, not because he's 6'10", because he has a strong IQ and a strong knack for the game, being a sophomore. Good post, catching the ball with two hands, and then attacking the rim. He's a special kind of player. I love watching this kid play.
There's no doubt about it. He's at the foul line. 1 for 2. At the line today, 5 points, 11 rebounds, give him 6 now, and a 4-point lead for Charlton County.
Just great hands, great body, strong knowledge and feel for the game, and he rebounds with two hands consistently.
Pass out to the 3, that would have been a big make right there, but Jarvis Wright couldn't get it to go down. He's 2 for 7 shooting the 3. Inside they go. They feed the low post, and a foul is going to be called. Let's see who this is going to be on. It looks like it's going to be on Jalen King in number 5.
Good basketball there by Wilkinson County. Not force. Get the ball to the high post. High post. Attack the rim with the swing step. And attacking the big guy. See, Williams can't foul. It's too early in the third quarter for him to contest shots. So you just got to be a presence and let the game kind of come to you on the defensive end.
Well, they can't let Jalen King get in foul trouble either. He now has 3. He has to come out of the game. And Imont Hamilton checks in for him.
Well, here's when that chess match starts. How do you play if you Charlton County? Do you play man or do you play zone to try to force the outside shot?
King gets the rebound. Got to hit your free throws. Jordan Jackson missed them both, especially in a tight game like this state championship game is going to be all the way down to the wire. King comes around to get the ball. Triple team, nice touch.
The patience by Williams, the patience. He catches the ball in mid-post. He looked opposite and saw, I can shoot this at 5 feet. Love his touch.
The patience is what you need. In the first half, guys were rushing it.
Yes.
There he slows down. I can do this. Don't have to rush my shot.
But look how he rebounds. I mean, that's textbook. Two hands every time and catch the ball at its peak.
8 points, 13 rebounds for Elias Williams, having a monster state championship game in Charlton County, leading by 6. Foul is going to be called on Wilco.
Williams is special. Look how he catches it, faces up. Look to the weak side, it wasn't there. He's not only got great hands, but he's got good offensive touch with the stroke and the easy two in the paint.
Timeout on the floor, 4:51 to play in the third. Indians up by 6.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMC support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMC's official energy provider of the GHSA.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs. And we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
we continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumbers!
Elias Williams, 8 points, 14 rebounds, 4 on the offensive glass, 5 block shots, and he's a team-high +9 when he's on the floor.
And, you know, he plays to his strength, not his weakness. His weakness is not outside the paint. Be a presence inside, and don't be selfish with the basketball. One thing I love about him on the court, Matt, is that it's not a black hole when it goes into his hands. He wants to get the team involved and then put himself in a position to score easily at the basket.
He's a willing passer. He knows when that double and triple team comes, his back to the basket, his job is to kick for the three.
Yeah. Be a presence down low. When the double team come, kicks it out, post, repost, catch it at the rim, and finish.
5-second violation on Charlton County. Wilco, 1-for-4 shooting in this quarter, and 9-for-37 in the game, just 24%. They're 0-for-5 on their threes, and they're 0-for-4 on their free throws. The drive, and missed the bank shot. Those are shots you just got to be able to hit. Cartier-Craig on the miss.
But the presence of Williams in the inside, it's a game changer. And here's a guy that got 5 blocks. So when you penetrate, you think about, is he going to come on over and contest my shot?
And that's going to be an offensive foul. Jarvis Wright now has 2 personal fouls.
Well, when you're a three-point shooter, your job is not to penetrate, it's to shoot the three. So you got to allow someone else to be the primary ball handler and put yourself in a position to catch and shoot, play to your strengths.
Jarvis Wright, one of the top three-point shooters in the country, 2-for-7 on his threes in this game, the mid-range and the miss, and another rebound by Williams.
But, you know, you talked about Williams blocking shots, but I wish there was a stat the way that he changed shots or contested shots, because he does a good job, can't block them all, but be there to be a presence.
Or a stat for fear of the block.
Oh, yes. Fear Williams.
I mean, because maybe that falls under the category of changing your shot. You see guys leaving it short. They're just afraid he's going to come up there and swat it away.
And that's when you have to have an offense that's set to get him away from the rim. You know, use the whoever he's defending, use him in a position to set ball screens, play more on the perimeter. That way he's outside of the paint and you can attack the rim.
Jarvis Wright pulls up inside the arc and misses. Rebound controlled by Wilco. That was Jordan Jackson pulling it down. He's got 6 boards in this game.
And if you look at Wright, what's happening is he's getting every shot contested. Every
nice
shot that he
takes
being contested.
That has a beautiful feed, and Jordan Jackson with the put in. That's what you got to do.
Well, you force it. Well,
penetrate.
Right. Penetrate. Kirk, Matt, you talk about it. Keep the big fella away from the rim. He can't contest the rim. He can't contest second chance opportunities. That was great offense there by Wilkinson County.
And as poorly as they played, as many shots as they have played or missed, they are down only 4 points. Stanley was called for the foul. That'll be number 1 on him. Under 3 minutes to play, third quarter. Drive, kick to the corner, 3, and air ball.
Great basketball. Just missed the shot.
Yeah. They did everything right but hit the shot. Mid-range, off the iron. Williams goes and gets another rebound. We'll have to send Nelly on an assignment to dig up what's the record for rebounds in a state championship game, because Williams now has 17 of them. I'm sure it's in the 20s.
I'm sure it is. But he not only rebounds in his space, he rebounds out of his space as well, too.
Foul called on Wilco. The Cartier-Craig picks up the foul. That's going to be number 3 on him.
with a player like Williams, I mean, he's just, like they, Coach said, he's a unicorn kind of athlete. The guy can rebound and he can run. He's got great hands. He's got soft touch. And more importantly, I like how he plays the game mentally. He's not rushed. He's not pushed outside the paint. Just plays his game. And remember, he's just a sophomore.
Morian Martin knocks down the free throw. Charlton County 6-for-9 at the foul line. Airballed the second attempt.
A minute and 55 here in the third. What's going to happen going into the fourth quarter is going to be fatigue. The fourth quarter, both teams are going to go 100 miles an hour the first 2 or 3 minutes. You'll see the fouls start to measure up, and then fatigue gets in. And that's when you really have to start playing smarter with the ball.
With the left hand, and there's Williams again. Just his presence. Possession arrows pointing Wilco's way on the tie-up. Now watch this. Watch how he just leaves the shot. Well, he got a piece of it. He actually got a block on that. I didn't see that in live time, but on the replay, he got a block.
Well, he's smart the way he defends. He contests the ball at his peak, rebounds with two hands, and that's the foul.
Coming over the back. Foul's going to be called on Jackson.
And that's the foul. The big fella is playing really good, really strong, but he's not forcing his body to be a Goliath. He's just rebounding in his space and inside his frame.
So Charlton County shooting the bonus here.
And he's not rattled. Look at him here at the free throw line. Just great IQ for a young player getting ready to get comfortable within his ability to play this game.
Wow, Wilco, man. They feel snake bitten, no doubt about it. They had the rebound and they kick it out of bounds. Xavier Whipple, the perfect man to succeed Dr. Aaron Jeter, who won 10 straight championships, or 10 state championships, I should say, for Wilco. Dr. Jeter came in when Xavier was in ninth grade. They won 2 state championships when Xavier was there playing. Of course, he went on to LSU, played a year in the G League. And now the head coach trying to win the first state championship since he's been the head coach.
And that's
inside,
a block.
That's going to be a blocking foul. No.
No,
they're
going to
call an offensive foul.
Well, I don't know about the call, but I applaud the effort by Williams getting the rebound and outrunning the entire defense back on court. I mean, you can't teach this. This is textbook, and this is more just heart hustle, and his foot may have been right there in the line.
I'd like to see the feet again. Was his foot inside the restricted area? But that's going to be the third personal foul that gets Williams off the floor for now, and a trap after they get the steal. And a timeout called by Charlton County, a 30-second timeout.
Well, let's talk about the adjustment there by Coach Bailey. Your best player goes out the game with his third foul. So instead of coming back to the same defense, what did they do? They press, forced a turnover. Now they got the possession again.
25-20. That was a big call on Elias Williams because that gives him 3 personal fouls. So I know you don't want to go in there and challenge Elias Williams because he keeps blocking your shot, but your best chance to win if you're Wilco is to get him fouled out of this game when he gets back out there.
Well, watch going into this last minute and 3 seconds what Charlton County does. They're going to force the tempo because they know that they feel they can press this Wilkinson County team. And now they're going to milk the clock. Let's get a good shot on this possession.
63 seconds left in the third quarter. Weaving through the defense, swatted at it. Wilco's got it. Break opportunity. And knocked away from behind. Great recovery by Jamari Hamilton. to prevent the layup.
Well, that's good gutsy basketball by Hamilton. No, he missed the teardrop mid-range jump shot, but he aggressively got back for the back tip.
Inside. Oh, my goodness. Hopefully Hamilton's okay. He fell hard on his back.
You see, this is a time of score situation. Don't force it. You, Carrollton County, bring it out and get one shot.
Charlton up by five. There's a difference of about a second and a half on the three-point or on the shot clock and the game clock.
And you can watch Coach Bale on the sideline. I'm telling you guys, one shot. We don't need to force it. Now you give up the possession, and now we give them the ball again.
Watch Jamari Hamilton. Ooh. Here. Wow. Right on his arm and his shoulder. Fortunately, they're teenagers. That's a big hospital bill for me.
Yes, it is.
Down to 1 second, and they don't get the shot off. You got to be aware of the clock, and you miss a golden opportunity to score the basket before the end of the third quarter. The Class 1A D2 state championship game. We're headed to the fourth quarter in Macon. Charlton County looking for their first ever state title, up by five.
While we have a quick break from the action, did you know that the same area of just one basketball court can contain thousands of termites? That's why you need the expertise of Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school basketball.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Sean Golden, John Nelson, and Hannah Gooden, thanks for joining us. Final 8 minutes, Charlton County trying to make history. Prior to this season, the deepest playoff run in Indians history, 1996. They got to the Elite Eight. David Bailey has turned them into a basketball power in South Georgia. When he first got there, he said, look, I was just teaching all the time. Now I get to coach.
Yeah, you look at him on the sideline. He's got that look. He's got the swag. And he's a rising star in this profession. But here's where you make your name, fourth quarter. Now, who's going to win the championship? There are a couple things we're going to look into. And Williams, everything's going to go through Williams if you're Charlton County.
They lob it into him. Pass out for the three. Three from the wing and an air ball for Jamari Hamilton. Charlton County now 3-for-13 shooting the three ball in this game.
Well, that's not their strength. Now, you know, Wilkinson County is going to double-team the post. Great opportunity to penetrate and get a deeper shot in the paint.
So can Wilco overcome their offensive woes? Up there, and they get the foul number 4 on Williams.
I was thinking about this going into the fourth quarter. Maybe too early to bring Williams in. He's got 3 fouls. Don't pick up the fourth early into the fourth quarter, and now he has to sit because he's going to contest shots. So now Wilkinson County, let's attack the big fella. Let's get him on the bench again and make a run.
Well, Sean, this is a major decision with 7 minutes and 33 seconds left in regulation. Do you take Williams out of the game? And there's the answer right there. He's coming out.
Well, you've got to. Let him sit, and let's make some strategy changes right here. Do you go half court with your defense? Do you stay in the zone, or do you start to press?
Now, all that said, until they start hitting free throws, it's not a story. That was the first free throw they had made in six attempts now. But there's a big difference in free throws and fourth quarter free throws. We'll see if they can knock down some fourth quarter free throws. They're down only four.
And this is when you're Charlton County. Let's run the offense. We don't need threes. We don't need quick baskets. Run the offense. Force the defense to recover. And then you attack the rim.
Wing three missed by Hamilton. Rebound cleared by Wilco. Corner three. Battle for the offensive rebound. They won it. Great job by Evans. And a timeout called by Xavier Whipple and Wilco. So the door is open right here for Wilkinson County, Sean, with Elias Williams on the bench for personal fouls.
But here's the thing about Wilkinson County. The entire game, their own players are shooting themselves in the foot. You're not getting it to your right players. Stanley, averaging 21 points a game, only has 6 points. Let me repeat that again. Your top scorer only has, 4 points. Think about that. You're trying to win a championship. That means the point guard is not getting it to him, and everyone is forcing their own shot.
So Stanley, who's 21 points per game, is 2 for 8 from the floor. Quavion Hill, 16 points per game. He's 3 of 14. Some nervous looks for the Warriors fans. And the foul is going to be an offensive foul, and that's going to go against Quavion Hill. That's going to be number 3 on him.
Well, everyone wants to get to the paint now. Force the drive. Good defense there by Wright, stepping in and taking a charge right between the numbers.
Back the other way in the basket for Charlton County. The lead is back to 6. Jamari Hamilton on the field goal. Mid-range jumper, just can't get it to go. Jordan Jackson keeping it alive. A tip attempt on the other side. We'll have a foul called on Charlton.
Well, this is new territory here for Charlton County. Why? Because usually the big fellas in the paint cleaning up the glass. Now everyone has to rebound, and they're accustomed to looking around for Williams, who's not there because he has 4 fouls now on the bench.
You saw David Bailey just signal. That's 4 fouls now on Jalen King as well. If they can get those two guys out of the game, then they should be able to penetrate and do what they like to do.
Well, you're going to
unabated.
Yeah, you're going to keep one of those guys in the game because you want King to still be a presence in the paint when it comes to rebounding.
Jalen King has been the heart and soul of this Charlton County team. They get the offensive rebound, then they throw it away. 13th turnover of the game on the Warriors.
And again, that's Stanley. I mean, that was shooting himself in the foot. You're the top shooter. Shoot the ball. Be aggressive. You can't be passive, especially here in the fourth quarter with 6:20 to go.
Wing three. Rebound again. 5-point lead, Charlton County. Attacking the basket. Finger roll. Offensive rebound. And missed the chance right up close. How many shots have they missed close? But they'll go to the line here with Travion Evans. A chance to cut the lead down to 3 if he can make the 2 free throws.
Well, here's the ghost of Elias Williams. He's there. He's in the paint. The ghost is. But you got to hit these baskets. I mean, if you're trying to win a championship, Evans, you got to hit that shot and get a 3-point play.
Travion Evans with the free throw make. Wipes off his hands and eyes the basket. Lead is down to 3. Less than 6 minutes now in regulation. Right. Shot blocked. They'll call a foul.
Well, here's 2 things with that, Matt. I'm not a fan of the shot because it was too early in the game, too early in the clock. He didn't have control of the ball. But defensively, you go and contest it, block a three. 9 times out of 10, it's going to be a foul. And now Charlton County has got a chance to get 3 points from the free throw line.
Full timeout called. We're down to 5:43 left in the state championship game. And a 3-point lead for the Indians.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
It's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Three to go. Wilco has now gone 5 minutes and 4 seconds since their last basket. They've missed 38 out of 48 shot attempts in this game. Yet, they're still only down three.
Well, they're trying to force the play. If you really look at it, the players who have not really shot the ball well all year long, all season long, now they want to be the Michael Jordans of the game. Get it to the players who got you here, and you'll be in a better position to win this championship.
Jarvis Wright at the foul line. Hitting three free throws after being fouled on the three-point shot attempt.
Now here's the defense. What happens? Are they going to press or fall back to a 2-3 zone? Here's the full court pressure. And see how they're playing. They're playing with inside the three-point line. They're giving up the three-point shot. And still, Wilkinson County is still trying to force it instead of taking their time, getting into the right shooters, Stanley that is, and give him an open look beyond the arc.
Still no Elias Williams on the floor. Jalen King remains out there with four personal fouls.
Well, we got another media coming up, and this is not the time to bring Williams in. You want to bring him in about 4 minutes to go in the game, possibly three, where he can have a strong presence down the stretch.
Tip in for Wilco. And Jordan Jackson getting it done on the offensive glass. 6 points, 8 rebounds for Jordan Jackson. The lead is three again.
Now, this is a good possession by Charlton County because nothing is forced. You're using some time on the clock, and there you get a wide open shot. See, a lot of times possessions, it's not about getting the first quick shot. It's about taking your time and getting a good, comfortable opportunity to score.
Jalen King with the corner three. Lead back to six. Wilco keeps it alive. Three-pointer from the top of the circle.
The first one he's had all night long, a catch-and-shoot shot. He's a three-point shooter, one of the best in the nation. You've got to stroke the ball, but you've got to find it so you can put yourself in position to get that open three.
Justin Stanley hits the first three-pointer for Wilco in this game, and then an offensive foul called on Charlton County. And Elias Williams comes back on the floor with 4:13 to play in the state championship game.
Well, that was the fifth foul there on King. Ball screens, screening away from the basket that far away, probably not a good thought process. But now, how do you change it? If you're Charlton County, we don't need ball screens. You need more action and movement. If you're Wilkinson County, now let's attack the big fella inside the paint.
Jalen King, who's been with Coach Bailey all four seasons, fouls out, 8 points, five rebounds. And a turnover for Wilco. 14 of those in this game, and Charlton turns it. Foul's going to be called on Charlton County. That's going to go against Demorian Martin. That's going to be number three on him.
And Martin is said to be the heart of the team, but offensively, he's got to slow down. You don't need a quick basket. You're up. You come down and try to make it up by getting a steal. Now you put them at the basket with a chance to cut into your lead with 3 minutes and 51 seconds to go.
Wilco, 4 for 10 at the foul line in this game. Cartier Craig eyes another. 2 more misses for Wilco at the free line.
And this is where it gets tight. Now, Charlton County, handle the press. Wilkinson County is coming to attack. How do you handle the press? Do you speed up and attack in transition, or do you kind of take your time and get yourself a great possession in the offensive end?
Stolen away by Craig. Gets it back to Craig. He challenges Williams and puts it in. First time they've been able to do that the entire game. The lead is down to one. And the call goes against Charlton.
Well, the press is effective for one main reason. Charlton County is trying to dribble through the press, and easily you can pass it through the press. This is a chance for you to put Williams in the middle of the press, throw over the top, and now he can pass the ball. So you can't force it with the dribble and expect to have an effective press breaker.
Hamilton simply stepped out of bounds. Chance for Wilco to take the lead. Pass back into the paint, intercepted by Wright.
Now this is when you slow down. Slow down, bring the ball back out.
And Martin missed the layup.
And see, you've got to be smart with the basketball. 3 minutes to go, you want to be able to win the game with your mind, not your athletic ability.
I can understand his frustration. Full court pressure.
Who's in the middle? You got to have the big fella in the middle. Williams should be in the middle. He needs to be an outlet.
Hamilton drives all the way, shoots it over the hoop. Wilco a chance to take their first lead of the game. 2.5 minutes to go. In the paint. Rebound Charlton.
Slow down. Bring the ball out. Bring the ball out.
There's no need to shoot that. Shot it with plus 25 on the shot clock, and you got the lead.
Man, I would love to be in the huddle right now because Coach Bailey is going to lose it. I'm telling you, the jacket's going to come off.
Wow. Timeout on the floor. 2:16 to go. 32-31. Indians lead by one.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton.
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day living in the right space. Got me feeling some kind of way.
why so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households, striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
2:16 to go in the Class 1A D2 Championship. Charlton County has never won it. Wilkinson County has won 10, but not since 2018. Indians lead the Warriors by one.
Smart basketball. Both teams not even thinking the game. You've got to think the game. But we got to realize these are young kids in high school. So it's up to the leaders on the court to really take over right now and play smart, aggressive, but yet smart basketball.
Again, Wilco comes down the floor, a chance to take the lead.
And you see how deep Wilkinson County, how Charlton County's playing? Play at the three-point line. We'll give you the open shot, but we're not giving you the penetration.
Spin move. And the first lead of the game for Wilco is Quavion Hill knocks down the jumper.
Now let's get it inside to the big fella. Move the ball around.
The drive and the foul called on Wilkinson County. And Jarvis Wright will go to the foul line.
That was a good two-man game there by Charlton County, because Wright, the guy, he can score the ball. He knows how to shoot it, gets to the free throw line. Ugly land there on his wrist.
Yeah, he fell on his wrist. Let's see if this impacts his shot. He's an 80% free throw shooter. Put back.
Wow.
And Williams is there to respond and come through big.
That was Hamilton.
Hamilton. Jamari Hamilton, pardon me. Back the other way, and the answer by Hill.
Well, now with what Wilkinson County doing, they're attacking from the baseline. Now the big fella has to come over, either defend or not defend.
Williams inside, puts it in. All of a sudden, we're scoring. 36-35, a minute to go. Williams now with a double-double, 10 points and 20 rebounds.
I think we have a box and one going on. Yes, exactly.
In the middle, the floater, rebound.
Yep.
And the foul is going to be called. If his own Williams, he's done. Elias Williams is just fouled out of the game.
Penetration.
That's a tough foul.
That's a tough foul. You got a guy that's going to rebound with two hands. He's not putting his body. He's scoring. He's rebounding in his space. The official has to see that and understand that. But from his angle, he thought he was over the back. And that's a tough call to call here in a championship game against pretty much the best player on the court.
10 points, 20 rebounds, 6 block shots. But he's done now for the final 44 seconds. And we're tied at 36. Some of the fans just can't bear to watch. Stanley gives him the lead with a clutch free throw, and it's 37-36.
Charlton County has 2 timeouts. Right now, 1 shot. You really need 1 shot. Don't force it.
Rebound, Wilco. They've got the ball, shot clock off. They got a foul.
And that's, and think about this. This team, Charlton County, unfortunately, they've been playing almost helter-skelter basketball, especially when Williams isn't in the game. Now everyone wants to come up and do something that they haven't done all season versus taking your time and getting a good shot. And now here you go down the court, and you've got Stanley at the free throw line to try to make it a three-point game.
Wilco 10-0 all time in state championship games. Two-point lead for Wilkinson County. They did not lead until late in the fourth quarter. Three-point lead as Stanley knocks down both. Charlton County uses their next-to-last timeout. So, okay, Coach, here you go. It's 25.9 left in regulation. Are you going right to the basket, getting a quick layup and get the two, cut it to one, or are you playing for three?
I'm going for the quick two. You still got a foul to give, but the three-point shot puts you to one possession unless you can get a second chance rebound and force it back out. Try to score quick, but not quick when you're out of control. Get a good shot. Maybe a high ball screen at half court so you can create some four-on-three opportunities, but you have to attack the rim.
39-36. Wilkinson County won their first state championship back in 1999 under the legendary Dr. Aaron Jeter. Xavier Whipple, who is now the head coach of the Warriors, was a sophomore that year.
Yeah, you know, this game here, you know, Dr. Jeter, I'm sure he's like, let's go. We need 11. Let's go. I set the tone. And Charlton County, you still have a chance. You can't be down on yourself. You got 26 seconds to go in the game. You got to be under control, though. You got to be under control.
Three-point lead. Full court pressure shown here by Wilco. Just to slow him down.
Is the high ball screen coming?
19 seconds to go. They give it to Wright. Wright will take a three and miss it. Chased down by Charlton. They throw it up for grabs. Wilco's got it. 8 seconds ahead. They're going to have to foul. Cross court. And the foul was called with 5.2 seconds left on the clock. And outside of two misses here at the free throw line, Wilco is going to win the state championship.
Now you think about the foul on his wrist. I mean, he misses both of those free throws. That was a good shot. That was his shot.
Yeah, that's his shot.
That's his shot. So you go back to the fall on his wrist. That may have made a slight difference in his follow-through or his stroke.
Clutch free throw. Quavion Hill has all but nailed down the championship for Wilco. Six rebounds for Quavion Hill. The miss, Charlton County trying to call a timeout, I think. Not going to matter. Let's see, did they call a timeout?
Yeah, he called a timeout. Called a timeout, maybe like 2.8, 3 seconds to go.
Let's see what kind of time they're going to give him on the clock here. So unless you can come up with a four-point play, get fouled on a three-point make.
Well, there's numerous actions where this could happen. It could easily be a five-point play. Back screen, ball screen, the shooter gets the open shot, and the defender runs over the screener. I mean, there's so many things that can happen. So don't think the game is over with. There's a lot of basketball to play.
5.4, exactly. I mean, the timeout must have been called from the bench, because they were clearly less than 5.4 when the dribbler was trying to call the timeout. So Bailey must have called that timeout right there from the bench because they put 5.4 back on the clock.
And the thing is, there's no four-point shot attempts. So if you're Wilkinson County, if I'm Coach Wilkins, guys, put your hands in your pockets and look. Do not touch. If you contest, Now you put us in a bad situation. The clock doesn't stop on a make shot. So basically, the game is over if they are smart and wise on how they play on the defensive end.
And Wilkinson County, which at one point had missed their first five free throws in this game, now 5 for 6 on their free throws here down the stretch. And as coaches will tell you, there are free throws, and then there's fourth quarter clutch free throws. And Wilco has taken care of business at the foul line. Now they're waiting to see where the ball is going to be inbounded. And they've changed it to 3.1, which is more appropriate.
And that's what I said, because the ball advanced to half court.
Right.
And that's when the timeout occurred.
Yeah, 5.4 was when they got the rebound, I think.
You know, you hear me say this often, El Matador defense. Don't touch, don't contest, don't do anything.
Don't move.
Ashley, guys, come back here to me.
Stand over here.
Stand over here with me.
Yeah, I mean,
I don't need you down there. Just let them have the basket.
Let them score.
You know, okay, now we have 4.4 seconds.
They've changed it again to 4.4. Interesting. I'm wondering why the confusion on what how much time there should be. They don't have a monitor that they can go to and figure out the time.
But again, go back to strategy. This is where Coach Wilpa has to coach his players. I'm not worried about the time. Guys, we got a four-point game. That's a two-possession game. There are no four-point shot opportunities. Step back. Stay beside me right now.
That's exactly what
they're doing.
While
they go out here and score.
That's exactly what they're doing.
No contest, no nothing. We don't care.
Yeah, Charlton County will inbounds with no defense. Of course, the clock will not stop until they touch the ball. And he's going to try and get a foul call. That's about as odd a scene as I have ever seen on a basketball court, where he was going to make a run at him and see if they would foul him.
But here's the thing I'm going to say. That's basketball coaching. That's coaching. That's coaching. Because you're like, guys, we don't need to contest. Listen, you're coaching high school players. I don't trust either one of you out here in this last 3 seconds of the game.
So now 0.9 seconds. And that will do it. Wilkinson County has won their 11th state championship. They trailed for 30 minutes in this game, but finally take the lead in the final 2 minutes and win the Class 1A D2 championship, the 11th in school history and the first for head coach Xavier Whipple.
Well, you got a dynasty there in Wilkinson County. You know, Dr. Jeter created something that's going to last forever, a legacy that's going to last forever. And now Coach Whipple is saying, I'm going to follow your footsteps, coach, and we're going to bring it home. Not just one, then a position to bring it home even more, because they're stacked going forward, because they've got a feeder program just in the community as well. Everyone wants to play basketball there for the Warriors.
Xavier Whipple, who starred there, three-time All-State, also an All-State quarterback in his playing days at Wilkinson County, now has a state championship trophy to go on his mantle as a head coach.
Such a great feeling and such a great game.
Let's send it down to John Nelson for the trophy presentation.
Bring the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hines.
Coach, it gives me great pleasure to give you the state champion runner-up trophy to Charlton County. Congratulations to you and your team and to the tremendous crowd that y'all brought. Nobody supports their kids any better than Charlton County. Thank you so much.
Can I say something later?
No.
And now it's time to present a trophy to a team that has had it do two hands worth in the past, and they got to find a third hand to do it and to do it. Once again, Dr. Robin Hines.
Congratulations to both teams. What a great game. And what I said about Charlton County communities Nobody supports their school better. I can honestly say the same thing about Wilkinson County. You guys always show up and support your guys. Thank you very much. Now, Coach, on behalf of our new sponsor, Breda, and the Georgia High School Association, it gives me great pleasure to award you with this well-earned state championship. How do you feel about your team, yourself, and your community?
Man, I'm just happy for my guys, man. They put in a lot of work. They had a different focus once we went into the playoffs. Every game, my coaching staff put together a plan to get to the next game, man, and we're here, and we're back on top.
Congratulations, Coach.
Title number 11 goes back to Irwinton, and we send it back to Atlanta, two titles down.
All right, thank you, Nelly. Do appreciate that. 40-36 the final. Sean, how about this Wilkinson County team on a day where they could not hit their shots and play the type of game that they played all year long? They found a way to win.
You got to find a way to win a championship. Championships aren't given to you. You got to find a way, whether it's loose balls, whether it's free throws, it's open shots, and just stay consistent. They attacked the rim at the right time. They got the big fella in foul trouble, and they capitalized when opportunities presented themselves.
Stick around. The Between Game Show is coming up, and then it's the 4A Girls Final at the top of the hour at 5 o'clock. Hannah Gooden, we'll have you when we come back from the break. And John Nelson will have the coach and player of the game coming up as well.
The best defense to stopping bugs and critters? That would be Breda Pest Management, protecting homes all over Georgia for nearly 50 years. See why so many homes are protected by Breda Pest Management at bredapest.com.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go plumber!
Edition. I'm Hannah Gooden. We're live from the GPB Sports Studios in Atlanta. The GHSA Single A Division II Boys Championship is in the book, so that's two down, 15 more to crown. Let's get you caught up on what you missed on the GPB Sports scoreboard. So here's the game that just ended. Wilkinson County earned its 11th state championship, first since 2018, and first for head coach Xavier Whipple, with a 40-36 win over Charlton County. Then today at 1, it was the Single A Division II girls' turn. Clinch County took down the defending champs, Lake Oconee, 45-42 for the Panthers' first state title since 1993. And this evening at 5 o'clock, it's the Quad A girls' turn, Baldwin versus Griffin. The Bears beat the Braves for the region title this season. And at 7 o'clock, it's the Quad A boys, Fayette County versus Pace Academy. The Tigers are hot on a 13-game win streak and looking for their first ever state title. Pace Academy won it all in 2021. For right now, we're going to send it to John Nelson at Macon Coliseum, who has Wilkinson County head coach Xavier Whipple and our player of the game.
Quavion Hill is the player of the game. Man, we're going to go and talk to Quavion first. We're going to let coach catch his breath a little bit. So, all right. Well, I didn't earn the right to touch this, so move that a little bit that way so they can see your face. There you go. There it is. All right, right there. How does it feel to have that
going back home?
Man, it feels amazing, man. Having my own state championship, you know, we got 10. So if, to come out and win my own, win my 11th one, you know, we got 11 seniors on the team, so I just feel like it was destined for it. It feels real good, man. You know, really emotional right now, though, but it feels good.
It was a tough game out there. Obviously, the rhythm was off and trying to get adjusted to shooting and buildings and rims and things like that. What was it like out there for you guys, knowing that you were trying to get into a rhythm and it just seemed to be stop-start the whole time?
For me, I know I had a tough time from three-point on this game. You know, I didn't let it get to me. I just tried to get in for the mid-range, mainly get to the rim, get some fouls, you know. But I didn't really let missing shots from three-point get to me. You know, I just tried to change up my game plan and do more on defense.
One more for you. Down the stretch, Clinch had the lead. You guys came back. What were the adjustments that you made? What did Coach talk to you guys about in the huddle?
First, defense. Get on the floor, get loose balls. You know, we weren't doing that in the first half. And I feel like that's why we weren't getting up. You know, we missed a lot of rebounds, a lot of charges. We took more charges in the first half, but, you know, we didn't do what was necessary to win in the first half at the time, you know. But going into the second half, I feel like we did all that plus 10, especially on the rebounding part. You know, Jordan Jackson, our center, I really thank him, man. You know, he did a crazy job down there with him before, man. That's a big guy. But Jordan did his thing.
All right. Congratulations. Once again, I have not earned the right to touch this. So can you pick this up and move it to like about right here so I can talk to the coach who's won a couple of these in his time?
Yeah, man.
Now as a coach,
yeah.
This is heading back to Irwinton.
Yeah.
You and I got the chance to catch up a little bit. Yeah. You know what this means with Dr. Jeter.
Yes.
And all of the history that's attached with the 10 titles that he won up the road.
Yes.
First and foremost, what's it like? Has it sunk in that this is heading back home with you as a coach?
To be honest, the group of guys that I have, man, that's all we've been talking about since the playoffs started. We refocused after the season ended, and that was our goal, man. So we already saw it. That's the way that we've been talking about. So it's not surprising to me. I knew with the group that I had coming back that we should be here at this time this year.
What was it like out there knowing that I know you want to run? I know you want to launch threes. I know you want to do things an entirely different way. And, I mean, the numbers in the first half, 8 of 33, you were 10 of 48 at one point from the floor.
Yeah.
And I know that you were getting frustrated out there. What was it like watching it, hoping and hoping and hoping that things would change, and it just seemed like, once again, that the game was frantic, but nothing was happening out there?
Well, me, personally, I did get frustrated at times, which I knew I shouldn't have because I've played in here a number of times and coached in here and know how games go in here. You don't just come in here and make shots. You know, it's totally different than playing in a high school gym. And even the court, when you pass the ball, it looks like it's closer or further. You'll be off with the pass. So I had to calm myself down some. You're like, you know, these guys, they had never played here. So, but it can be frustrating, but I just told them to keep grinding and keep playing defense and rebounding, because that's what wins you games in this Coliseum.
Take me through the fourth quarter, and I know that you're down at the half by three. Mm-hmm. Clinch gets on a little bit of a run. Charlton gets on a bit of a run. Mm-hmm. They get the lead, then you're having to fight back. Take me through that fourth quarter and when you finally push through that wall to get the lead and get the win.
Well, it's all about just keep believing in what you believe in, and that's defense and rebounding. And if you keep doing that, and then once again you get late in the game, guys' legs start to go, and if you keep doing it and keep grinding, the game will eventually change for you. Some guys will turn the ball over. We jumped in a press there when a couple of guys went out and they turned it over two times. You just have to pick and choose your moments to try to change the game a little bit, and that's what we did.
For those that have never seen it, my last question for you. For those that have never seen it, we finally got the chance to show what that Wilco power is. And there was a lot of Wilco here.
Yeah.
Not a surprise.
No.
What was it like to see all of it be that fifth man, that sixth man for you, that 12th to 13th? What was it like to see all this support here?
Man, it's I was just telling my guys, man, let's just keep playing, because once you get to the fourth quarter, they've been here. We've been here a number of times that we were down. And you just have to keep, you have to keep pushing, and then they'll take over. The crowd will take over. It'll you know, they'll keep, you know, keep you going, keep you on your toes, and they'll be coaching from behind. Yeah, that's so they keep the guys, you know, they keep them where they need to be, and man, and no other crowd like Wilkinson County in here, man.
Because the Macon Coliseum is once again Whippleville.
Hey, Whippleville.
Xavier Whipple, now head coach of Wilco, taking this number 11 back. We got to catch up with Quavion Hill, player of the game here once
That's
again.
That's actually my little cousin.
Yeah. Yeah, little cousin.
Little. Big, little.
That's your little cousin. Uh-huh. Right.
It's my cousin.
There you go. That's a cousin. Title's heading back to Irwinton. Let's send it back to Atlanta, Hannah.